Which is the ancient period for bless you, Yahweh, bless you, Yahweh Shai, that's Barakata, Yahweh, Barakata Yahushai. Kalal Aliyum is all praises, lies to Yahweh, Heavenly Father's only name, Bahara Kakadash, in the Holy Spirit, or Slakya Bahar, is in the Yahweh Shai, being the Son's only name, who the world ignorantly calls Jah Jehovah, Jesus Yeshua, etc. In the Holy Spirit, which is the wisdom and understanding of the Holy Scriptures. Double honesty, apostles, and those of greatness to him, saw he teaches 144,000 men, the 1/3 men, women, and children that he saved. This is where you have a second GMS one. I just want to do a lesson off the heels of Elder Manatha Zagba. Share this video among us, and I was thinking to do a lesson on it or not, but you got to think about the times of men falling out and giving up and turning their backs, not keeping their hands on the plow, it's like, to be honest. I got that doubt demon being on my mind, it's like, not worthy, your own mind condemning you, but you gotta meditate in these precepts, I was about to go to sleep last night, I was listening to a few psalms, I cried out to Yahweh, praying for mercy and whatnot, because we gotta pray for mercy. We don't know, we don't know what Yahweh shall full will. So it's until that day, then we shall know who Yahweh's chosen. We gotta keep our due diligence, we gotta keep pushing, gotta keep on fighting on to death, That's why I named my channel iL-Mawath. Naba'ah is prophesy, iL is unto, Mawath is death, alright? That's what I want to do. I want to keep prophesying unto death. And Manatha Zagba did this lesson on this guy. Can't remember his name right now, but the account. This is not a story. This is a true shit. The account is it's admonishment. It's warning. Like one of the brothers in the camp named Iriya, it's warning. Or watchful. Gotta watch ourselves in this trip. Make sure that we're not flattering ourselves or even anyone in the camp or so forth. Because let me just play a bit of the bass. Just turn on the volume a bit. I'm sure.
But the anointing which you have received of him.
Of who?
Of him.
A fucking man.
Of him.
No, that nigga in Atlanta.
Of him.
That motherfucker in New York.
No.
What about that nigga in L.A.?
No.
What about that motherfucker down there? What about all these motherfuckers?
No.
What about him? Brother, go ahead.
So deeper than that too, man.
Tell you, man.
Yourself.
Y'all right, yeah. Y'all, a lot of you motherfuckers scared of El Tom, man. A lot of you motherfuckers scared of Elder Gabbar. A lot of you motherfuckers scared of Elder Ram Ram. A lot of y'all scared of Elder Ricardo gonna bust your motherfuckers.
A lot of you motherfuckers are scared of 34th and 7th. Period, man.
Period, man.
You
Elder Ricardo gonna bust your motherfuckers.
What y'all learn from? What's that learn from?
We learn from the Bible, bro. Don't bring that over here. Okay?
Who talking?
The Most High. Wisdom.
Through who?
are we in a shot in GMS? You know why we say that? You go down to 34-7 and confound the elders of GMS and prove them that they're false prophets, I will denounce the Yahweh Bashi Yahweh Shah in GMS. You know why we say that? Because it ain't gonna fucking happen. So you can finish clicking your fucking caps lock and your tab key and scoffing at the elders while you want the Lord's will destroy you. And you're gonna have to eat your keyboard. Watch that.
Oh man, Tahar, T-God, Gabor, Aramlon, Jason. You ain't fucking Ricard, you Jason, hoe ass nigga. And when I
United make real bread together, period, playing brain. That-
to the apostles and elders. Yeah, so that's that guy, you know. That guy, yeah. Turns back on Al-Bash and O'Shea. So let me get into these precepts real quick. Psalms chapter 12. Yeah, yeah, I'm going to name this week lessons like it. Help, Yahweh. Well, God demands ceaseth for the faithful field. Among the children of men, right? And yeah, we need help because we don't want to be a godly man that ceases our fear from among the children of men. You know, that's our prayer. Verse 2, it says, they speak vanity, everyone with his neighbor, flattering lips, and with a double heart. Saying all these things, flattering lips. And we're speaking flattery at that time. You know, deep down, you know, it's true nature, the reveal. You know, let me get these over with. It says, Yahweh will cut off all flattering lips. The tongue that speaketh proud things. Who have said with our tongue we will prevail, our lips are our own. Who is Lord over us? Yeah. So he was going against the apostles. And believe it or not, the apostles are Lord over us. You know? They're Lord over us. You know, they watch for our souls. That's why they keep putting all these lessons in DVD. For the oppression of the poor, for the sight of the needy. Now will I arise, saith Yahweh, I will set him in safety from him that profiteth him. See? So he's oppressing the poor, he's oppressing the apostles and elders and all the other brothers down because we mourn together for the destruction of this place. And for a man who's trying to destroy everything that Yahweh Bashi Yahweh built, you know, is oppression. For the sighting of the needy, now will I arise, say to Yahweh, I will set him in safety from him that puffeth at him. That goes to Esau, and these 2/3 that puffeth at us. The words of Yahweh are pure words, as silver tried in the furnace of earth. Purified 7 times, thou shalt keep them, O Yahweh, thou shalt preserve them from this generation. The wicked walk on every side. When the vilest men are exalted. So these wicked men will walk on every side, and Esau is being exalted, you know. They're exalting Esau in this. We get Psalms 5. Now verse 1, it says, give ear my words, O Yahweh, consider my meditation. So you want Yahweh Bashi should give ear to our words that we teach while we pray and so forth. You know, because we constantly meditate on the scriptures and the destruction of this place and the kingdom. You know, hearken unto the voice of my cry, my king and my power. Unto thee will I pray. My voice shall thou hear in the morning and in the morning. morning that I did my prayer. First, my prayer unto thee, and will look up. For thou art not a power that hath pleasure in wickedness, neither shall evil dwell with thee. So the Most High knew the intent of this guy's heart from the beginning, you know. For thou art not a power that hath pleasure in wickedness, neither shall evil dwell with thee. So Most High, whoever make wickedness this guy been doing, who knows he was doing wickedness. Yeah, but that's how it starts when, you know, scripture says when pride is the beginning of sin. So he was probably prideful behind the scenes, and then eventually fell out, you know. So the foolish shall not stand in thy sight. Thou hatest all workers of iniquity. Thou shalt destroy them that speak leasing. Yahweh will abhor the bloody deceitful man. But as to me, I will come into thy house with a multitude, in the multitude of thy mercy, and in thy fear will I, and in thy fear will I worship toward thy holy temple. See, and this is what we pray in verse 8, Lord. Verse 8, lead me, O Yahweh, in thy righteousness because of my enemies. Make thy way straight before my face. Right? This is what we're praying, bro. This is what we're praying. That the Most have mercy upon us. Let's see. Yeah, this is Psalms chapter 4, verse 3. But know that Yahweh had set apart him that is godly for himself. Yahweh will hear when I call unto him. See that? Moses set aside the godly for himself. All these ungodly men and women, Moses is going to cast off even if they're children. Right? Moses is just in everything he does. Right? It says, but know that Yahweh, it's like verse 4, stand in awe and sin not, commune with your own heart upon your bed. Still, Selah. Offer sacrifices of righteousness and put your trust in Yahweh. So we gotta put our trust in Yahweh, Bashim, Roshai, and let no man take our crown, even ourselves. Verse 6, it says, there be many that say, who will shew us any good? Yahweh, lift thou up the light of thy countenance upon us. And that's the thing, you know, Elder, that God was saying. That there was some men saying, if this guy is still teaching, because if you check their pages, they haven't done a video in a year, you know, and they started a group page, Israelite Tried and Refined, ITR, now, and they were trying to debunk every breakdown coming out of the Apostle Tahar entirely, you know. It says, there be many that say, who will shew us any good? Yahweh, lift up thy light. Thy countenance upon us, yeah, Yahweh, you know, lift up your light, your countenance upon us, because they were forsaken, but they let the blind lead the blind, you know? They thought they saw the light, but it was darkness, it was seen. Verse 7 says, thou hast put gladness in my heart, more than the time that their corn and their wine increase. You see, smoking blunts and throwing up money and whatnot. The Most High put gladness in our heart because why? We're not in that lot. No, we're praying we're not in that lot. We're praying that we remain steady and focused. It says, I will lay me both down in peace and sleep, for thou, Yahweh, only makes me to dwell in safety. Yeah, we're going to sleep sound because we're going to put our trust in Yahweh, Bash, you know, Shai. This is 1 John 2:19. I post this precept on this same channel. That did this a while back, you know. Brothers did a lesson with the same precept, and, you know, it stuck with me, it stuck in my spirit, and always remember to never give up. To never give up, you know. This is 1 John 2:19. It says, they went out from us, but they were not of us. For if they had been of us, they would no doubt have continued with us. But they went out that they might be made manifest that they were not all of us, right? But he have an unction from the Holy One, and he know all things. We have an anointing together, the word, unction, things smeared on, right? written unto you, because ye know not the truth, but because ye know it. And there is no lie of the truth, right? So these things are white written unto us because we know the truth. Double honor to the apostle, the elders, the priest, and the son, and salutation to the 144,000 men, the 1/3 men, and the children that they saved. Keep praying, keep staying focused. Don't take that vaccine, don't take that chip. Bad bubble, a bad bubble, a bad bubble. Shalom.